the Virgin Mary and became mama. For our sins, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, whom the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who was spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us ask the Heavenly Father to fill us with the Holy Spirit, aid us in our wickedness, and be our advocate and guide, full of trust. Father, fill us with your Holy Spirit.
Father, fill us with your Holy Spirit. Father, fill our hearts with your Spirit, that they may be empowered to call you Abba, Father, and live as your sons and daughters. We pray.
Father, fill us with your Holy Spirit.
Father, send your Spirit to the church and endow her with a variety of charisms and ministries that the Spirit inspires for her good. We pray.
Father, fill us with your Holy Spirit.
Father, pour out your Spirit on the leaders of our nation that may use their power and authority in the service and liberation of our people. We pray.
Father, fill us with your Holy Spirit.
Father, fill missionaries and workers of evangelization with your Spirit, that the good news of salvation may reach the whole world and the people may come to know you and your Son Jesus. We pray.
Father, fill us with your Holy Spirit.
Father, send your Holy Spirit to comfort the sick and the dying, and to give eternal life to those who have died. We pray.
Father, fill us with your Holy Spirit.
Father in heaven, listen to your people gathered in prayer. Send us your Holy Spirit, and transform us as you transform the disciples at Pentecost. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
brethren, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that as promised by your Son, the Holy Spirit may reveal to us more abundantly the hidden mysteries of his sacrifice and graciously lead us into all truth. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Give up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, for bringing your Paschal mystery to completion. You bestow the Holy Spirit today on those you made your adopted children by uniting them to your only begotten Son. This same Spirit, as the Church calls to birth, open to all peoples the knowledge of God, and brought together the many languages of the earth in profession of the one faith. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. In all things may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your holy family, of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those who have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, Almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. That you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and to accept them as ones you were pleased to accept, the gifts of your servants Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offerings of your high priest, Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation of the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son. and be filled. With the grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also your servants, whom have gone before us with a sign of faith, and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who through sinners, hold in your abundant mercy, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Lorenzo Ruiz, Pedro Calunson, and all your saints, admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with light, and bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Truly be filled with the Holy Spirit. Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Be with you. Is with you.
Thank you.
Let us kneel for the prayer against the death penalty. Father, source and giver of life, we lift our hearts and voices to you. Help us to build a society that truly chooses life in all situations. Let our response be, Lord, heal our pain. For those experiencing pain and anguish because of violence and crime, response, Lord, heal our pain. For perpetrators and victims of atrocities who both struggle with anger and hatred, response,
Lord, heal our pain.
For our broken world, enchained by the desire for revenge, response,
Lord, heal our pain.
For our wounded society, misled by the illusion that one must take life in order to defend it, response,
Lord, heal our pain.
Let us say together, help us to make peace. Tempted to accept violent revenge, response, for the conviction to recognize and uphold the dignity of all people, response, for the wisdom to see poverty, injustice, and lack of educational and employment opportunities as likely causes of criminality, response, for guidance and compassion in addressing the pain of both victims and perpetrators of wrongdoing. Response. For the fortitude to find solutions that protect the dignity of all people and bring about true reconciliation. Response. For the inspiration to renew society on the basis of love and restorative justice. Let us pray. Father of compassion, you let your rain fall on the just and the unjust. Give us a heart like yours, so that we may love as you know, even those who have caused us pain. There is in our land a cry for vengeance and a move to fill up death rows and kill offenders, but disguised as a call for justice. Let true and lasting justice spring forth. Jesus, our brother, you suffered execution in the hands of the powerful, but you did not let hatred overcome you. Help us to reach out to victims of violence, so that our enduring love may help heal their wounds. Holy Spirit, Lord and giver of life, you strengthen us in the struggle for justice. Help us to work against state sanctioned death, and to renew society in truth, justice, love, and respect, so that violence will cease and peace may prevail. Amen. O Mary, Mother of Life, protect the Filipino people from the forces of death. San Lorenzo Ruiz, San Pedro Calungsod, St. Paul the First Hermit, San Martin de Porres,
O God, who bestow heavenly gifts upon your choice, safeguard, we pray, the grace you have given, that the gift of the Holy Spirit poured out upon them may retain all its force, and that the spiritual fruit may gain her abundance of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Tunais lang po natin pagdibayon yung ating po devotion, devotional practice na aking sinasuggest para po sa pagkapahalaga sa buhay. Sabi mo po, every time na meron tayong mabalitaan na namatay, we pray one Hail Mary. One Hail Mary sa bawat isang namatay. Para siya ay magamit ng kaluwalhatiang walang katapusan, makamit niya ang buhay na walang hanggan na ipinangako ng Diyos. Pangalawa ay para doon sa kung sakaling ang namatay ay pinatay, para doon sa pumatay, para magbalik doon siya sa Diyos. Pangatlo, isang Hail Mary na kung saan makita natin para naman doon sa naulila ng namatay upang magkaroon siya ng kapanatagan ng kaluhuman. Sila, magkaroon sila ng kapanatagan ng kaluhuman sapagkat ang isa sa mga biyaya na ibinibigay ng Pentecostes ay rin kapayapaan. So kung tutusin po, hindi lang po yung namatay na babagabang, pati yung mga tao sa paligid niya. Pero tumulong tatlo nito. Siya namatay, kung sakaling ang namatay ay pinatay, pangalawa doon sa pumatay. Pangatlo, para sa mga nangulira ng namatay. One Hail Mary, bawat isang namatay. So hindi po kailan sa inyo na makailan lamang ay mayroong 38 namatay kasama na yung gunman o yung manulo sa Resort Manila. So, panalangin natin. Hindi ko lang alam kung ilan yung namatay ngayong araw na ito. No? Na pinagasa. Pero ibig sabihin, sa lahat ng mga namatay sa araw na ito, alisama ko natin para sa intention. Kasi nakakalungkot isipin. Kasi para tayong nasa warzone. Pero yung 38 na buhay ang nawala sa isang siklak. So, ipanalangin po natin. So, for today, we just pray one Hail Mary sa lahat ng mga namatay sa araw na ito. Pero sana po yung practice natin na one Hail Mary sa bawat isang namatay, sa bawat pumatay, at sa bawat mga kamag-anak na namatay. Yun ang huwag natin kalimutan na intention. So today, para makita po natin, kailangan natin one Hail Mary. Nung sa manapagin ng intention. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. May the Holy Spirit fill us and strengthen us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and ask for God's blessing, for every blessing. Let your response be, Amen. May God, the Father of lights, who are pleased to enlighten the disciple minds by the outpouring of the Spirit, the Paraclete grant you gladness by his blessing and make you always abound with the gifts of the same Spirit.
Amen.
May the wondrous flame that appear above the disciples powerfully cleanse your hearts from every evil and pervade them with its purifying light.
Amen.
And may God, who has been pleased to unite many times in the profession of one faith, give you perseverance in the same faith. And by believing, may you journey from hope to clear vision.
Amen.
And may the Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go with the love and mercy of our